something really astonishing happened. And I think it could only have happened to a single generation of Americans growing up during the 1950s and the 1960s. It'll never be duplicated, but the long-playing record was invented. And suddenly, and the hi-fi was invented. And suddenly, one could have virtually a version, a recording of every single piece of music that ever was. Because during that 10-year period, every piece of music that could possibly be recorded and played was recorded and played. And for the first time in history, it's sort of like the experience of the web in the 21st century, but it was in music. Suddenly, you could go to it was called a record store, and you could get the Beethoven symphonies, the Schumann symphonies, Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, early music, Palestrina, and Stravinsky, and suddenly the world of Beethoven, Bartok, Bach, Schoenberg, anything, Hindemith, anything that you could put, the great symphonists, Gershwin, anything that you could possibly think of was there, and of course, all of it. I listened to all of it and absorbed all of it. And simultaneous with that was, of course, you were in the middle of still the golden age of American songwriting. Great, great songs were on the radio. And simultaneous with that was the development and the evolution of pop music from Shaboom straight through to rock and roll and the Everly Brothers and ultimately the Beatles and Elvis Presley. And simultaneous with that was really the golden age of cool jazz and of mainstream jazz and bebop jazz. And since I lived in Jersey City, which was a stone's throw away from New York, we listened to it all the time. I remember going to Birdland. I remember seeing Dizzy Gillespie, seeing Thelonious Monk walk back and forth and decide whether he was going to play or not in his long trench coat. And being raised on it, and raised on all of that music, I would always go back to the piano. And you know, if I heard, I played jazz. I bought myself a set of vibes, and I played in a jazz band, and I played rock. Obviously, from having learned stringed instrument with my dad, and so we have this extraordinary golden age of the availability of every great piece of classical music, the availability of the evolution of rock and roll, the availability of everybody from Miles Davis to the modern jazz quartet that were linking together Bach. Counterpoint with swing and modern jazz. Louis Armstrong was still alive. Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. We could go on and on. Simultaneous with that, we were in a golden age of film scoring. And I would come home from seeing Taras Bulba with a fantastic score by Dmitri Tiomkin and run to the piano and start playing from memory, or as best I could, the score I had just heard. And you know, we all think of what the theme from The Apartment and of all of the great movie themes. And simultaneous with that was the rise of folk music. And I can remember being a teenager and going to The Bitter End and seeing Peter, Paul and Mary, and opening for them would be a comedian named Woody Allen, who was a stand-up at that time. And so I don't think there will ever be again an explosion, a simultaneity of all of those things that were available to you constantly. You could go see it live, you could buy a recording, you could listen to it on the radio. There was Top 40 radio. I went to sleep every night listening to Symphony Sid, which was the jazz program, or listening to WQXR. So because of that, I think that I really am a member of the first generation that has a sense of an absolute democracy of musical style. For the first time, there was never serious music as opposed to non-serious music. All music was serious in its own way. In addition to all of the various styles and modes and formats of music that one was exposed to during the 50s and the early 60s, it was, of course, still the great golden age of Broadway. And I can remember, like it was yesterday, the first piece of musical theater that I saw. I was My Fair Lady with Rex Harrison and Julie Andrews. And I think that was absolutely the moment I knew in my heart that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to write musicals. I also wanted to be Beethoven and write symphonies. And I wanted to be Elvis Presley. But I think more than anything else, the combination of the wit, the drama, the vitality, the sophistication, and yet simplicity of the music at the same time, the dominance of melody, the interaction of words with drama, I think I knew then.